Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from Robojax. In this video, we are going to check the available Wi-Fi or access points around you and display it on LCD. The code that I've written will display the channel SSID and the signal strength in terms of dB milli, and also I've written a function that converts it an approximate percent strength. ESP8266, either D1 mini, D1, different type of node MCU modules to do the scan of Wi-Fi and display them on the screen, either as a strength of dB milli or as percent. So you can select whichever you want. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. I've published another video lecture that displays almost all features of Wi-Fi scan from ESP8266. It displays almost all features that is available on the serial monitor, including the SSID, channel, encryption type, whether if the channel is open, the MAC address, and many other features. In this video, we're just going to display the strength of a signal of access points around you. And there will be two features available. Either you can display it as dB milli, which is the industry standard way to display it, and also to display it in terms of percent. Displaying in terms of percent is a little tricky way to display the value, or it is a relative based on how you see it. And there are different companies or industry leaders have developed their own method to display it as a bar graph or a value. So you will set your own minimum signal strength and also your maximum, and based on these two boundaries you can display it in terms of percent between 0 to 100. A separate video explaining this LCD1602 with I2C, which uses only four wires, two for power, two for I2C communication. I'm not going to explain those. The link will be provided. Watch it, download also the library. The link will be below the video. Make sure it works before you come to this video. And also I have separate video explaining the ESP8266, including how to install or prepare your Arduino and get the driver so your environment is ready for this. I'm not going to explain that. The link will be available for that as well. Without further ado, let's get started. Let me now explain the wiring. D2 is SDA and D1 is SCL. This will be available in the page that you download the code. This LCD will work with majority of these, but we have to pay attention. For example, this one has already the 5 volts pin, so you can connect it into this one. Or if you have this black Waymo's D1, this also has 5 volts, you can connect this. But for these modules, these two that I have here and these two other smaller, keep that in mind that in these two different modules that you see here, this has VN and VU. So VU is the one that is providing 5 volts. In both cases, you see VU, not VN. But in this module, the VN is the one that you connect. There's no harm if you connect it just this 5 volt from this, just connect it to VN or VU, whichever turns it on, that's the pin that will work for you. And this module that is sold like this, I've not soldered it yet. So for this module, there is no 5 volts pin, but if you want to use it and you have no choice, solder a wire here. This is a 5 volts pin, exactly the same pin as here, because the soldering and disconnecting a wire to the other pin will be hard, and this is very strong, so you can solder a wire here and get 5 volts. This device, we have ground. Ground have been connected to the GND or ground pin here. The second pin is VCC. From this module, it has been connected to the 5 volts, to the last pin here. And if you're using any of these other modules, they all have 5 volts. The last pin, the last two pin are for I2C communication. SDA have been connected. You see this SDA is a gray pin 2, and SCL is to pin 1, D1. So D1 and D2 are also exactly the same standard on all of these modules, so you can connect it. And if you use this module, exactly the same, except the SDN SCL have been prepared like an ordinary Arduino at this point, SDN SCL. So you will connect SDN SCL to this. Now let me explain the code. Your Arduino must be prepared for ESP8266. I have a separate video, the link will be provided. Follow that and make sure it works. After that, you have to install this library and make sure you are able to display a text before coming to this sketch. So I have a separate video for the LCD screen. Please follow that. When you download this, this will be a zip file on your computer. Save it on your computer. Go to sketch, include library, add.zip library, and then point it to where you have saved your zip file. For example, if the zip was this, point it to that, click, it's highlighted, and click open. Then the library will be installed. The explanation is that this is part of driver for the ESP8266, which I have separate video, you have to follow that. This RSSI max is a variable of type integer. We have set it as constant, so this cannot change, and also for the minimum, as well it's constant. And minus 50 is the maximum signal strength. Above that will be treated as 100%, and minus 100 is the lowest. And below this we will treat it as zero. And this line constant display percent, if you want to display the percent here instead of dB milli, set this to one. Otherwise zero will display dB milli. This is the library that you have to download and include, which I just shown you. And from this class, we create an instance of the class, we call it LCD, and we pass the I2C address of the LCD to find out this address. For example, the address for this one is 026, and for the other one as well, it is 0x3f. So 0x refers to hexadecimal, and 3f is of hex value. I will provide you the code for the I2C scanner. Just copy and paste it in a blank code, upload it. Once the code is uploaded, and we have set this to 9600 baud, open the serial monitor, make sure 9600 baud for this purpose, and you will see the address. It shows 0x3f. So now we know our address is 0x3f. Let me change it back to 115,200 that is needed for the module, and then close the I2C scanner. So we type this 3f, 0x3f. 16 is the number of characters. 16 is the number of characters, and then 2 is the number of line, 1, 2. And then this count is internally, do not worry about it. Scan delay time, this is the time that delays between each scan time. So if you want to keep it longer, let's say you want to scan it every half an hour, just for half an hour it is 60 times 30 times 1000. Put that here and it will be every half an hour it will scan. Otherwise you can scan it faster. So there is now, it's 1 second, and this 3 second is the time that for each SSID it is displayed. Now it's 3 second, then it goes to number 3, and so you can change that. Inside the setup, this is initializing the Wi-Fi station, and then disconnecting. And LCD begin initializes the LCD. This is turning on the backlight, and then we are printing the text. Let me reset it so you will see that this is the text, and then Wi-Fi demo is this line. So we use LCD set cursor 01, that means character 0, line 1. So this is line 0 and that is line 1. So this moves the cursor. After this, this goes to the next line to print this, and we give the user 2 seconds to read it and exit. Inside the loop, the code will run continuously. So Wi-Fi.scanNetworks, this will get number of available networks and store it in a variable called n, and we clear the screen from previous value, then print scan done. When it is done, And if scan is, if the Wi-Fi is equal zero, let's say there is no Wi-Fi around you, you will see no Wi-Fi found. Else means otherwise, we set to cursor 0 line 1, and then we print the number of network found, and we say, let's say if this was 5, 5 access point found. Let me reset it so you can see. This is the value. It says 20 AP found, scan done, 20 AP found. So this is the one that it shows that. And we give a little time, the same time that you have set above. And then the for loop goes through each network of n, whatever is n, I integer I start equals 0 until it is smaller than n and incremented. And then we clear the screen from previous values, set the cursor at 0, 0, which means we set it here, 0, character 0, line 0. And then we increment 0 plus 1 because it starts with 0, so we want to put 1, 2, 3. This is now 12, 12 plus 1 makes it 13, that's why. And then we put this close parenthesis, and then we print the SSID with a little space, as you see this one. Then we go to the next line with character 0 of next line 1, and then we print this text, we call it strength. You see the text is printed here, and then if the display percent have been selected, we get the SSID, the strength of the signal. We pass it to this function, which I will explain it later, it's below the code, and then we print the percent here. If not, we print the value, and we print DBM, which is this one. And then we wait for the display, Wi-Fi display time that we set above, and then scan time that we set above, and the loop will continuously monitor the network. Now, this is a number like minus 63 without DBM, or some value of minus 83. This number goes to this function. Let's see what happens. This function is below at the end. When it comes here, we call it DBM of type integer variable, and we define an integer quality. And then we check if this DBM is smaller than minimum, which means the signal is very low. So we treat it immediately. We set the quality equal 0. If this DBM is above the maximum, we call it 100%. Else, we do the calculation. So this calculation takes the value, adds 100, and multiplies it by 2, will give you the quality. Will give you the quality in terms of percent, and this will return. That is why the number here will be printed on the screen as a percent, not this one, which I will demonstrate later. Now let me demonstrate it. When you reboot it, this is how it shows. After that, it shows how many AP access points have been found, and then it displays the value. This is the SSID name, the Wi-Fi channel name. This is the SSID name, and this is the strength in dB milli. You can select it from the code. You can select it from here to be percent. If I select one and upload, and here now it has changed to percent, 17 access point found. So now it shows in terms of percent, 30%, which means it's very weak. 22%, 36%, and those that are very close, you will see very strong signal. Now it's almost more weak again. Very strong. And our channel Robojax is just beside me, about 2 meters away, a meter away. So we should get above 90% or maybe 100%. So 100%, and then Robojax is also 100%. Thank you for watching. This was how to display the signal strength in terms of dB milli or percent on LCD1602 with I2C module. If you found this useful and learned something, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you have not subscribed and want to get updates of my upcoming videos, you may subscribe now.